Back live now, and that profile, of course, was narrated by our colleague Ray Gandolf. Now here come the swimmers for the 100-meter breaststroke for men. Steve Lundquist, whom you've just met, a man whose talent and whose mercurial personality have held us all in thrall, those of us who follow the sport, ever since he really burst on the scene in 1978. There is Lundquist as he walks along the deck next to the warm-up pool and heads for the blocks. And John Moffitt will swim in the event. That is the latest word. The man just behind Lundquist is Brett Stocks, 21-year-old from Australia. And there is Moffitt, who appears, Mark Spitz, to be limping as he walks along the pool. I don't know him well enough to say for sure, but that looks to me like a limp.
Well, Jim, we know as a fact that he had a groin injury earlier this year, but like I said the other day, this is the biggest and possibly the most severe duel that we're going to see, and this may be just a little psych job. I want to document that because we don't know for sure. It wasn't evident in the prelims, but I want to give him the benefit of the doubt. He has a lot of courage for being out here, and of course, Steve Lundquist is wondering whether or not it really is as serious as it appeared to be.
The world record in the event is held by John Moffitt at 1:02.13. It was set earlier this year. Now there's Adrian Moorhouse of Great Britain, who will be swimming in lane one. We know he has the speed to win because earlier in his career he swam the fastest breaststroke relay leg ever in swimming history. And there's a good look at Steve Lundquist, world champion, Pan American Games champion, former world record holder, and about to swim the most important 100-meter breaststroke race of his life. And there is Brett Stocks of Australia. The Australians have been impressive here today. He beat former world record holder Gerald Morkin of the Federal Republic of Germany in his qualifying heat. Ranked 18th in the world last year, but here he is in the Olympic final. Now here is the leading qualifier, swam within 3/100ths of a second of his own world record in his qualifying heat this morning, John Moffitt, 20 years old from Costa Mesa, California. He was the youngest member of the 1980 American Olympic men's swimming team, which did not get to go to Moscow. In lane five, Peter Evans, 22 years old from Australia, second fastest qualifier this morning, significantly faster, for instance, than Lundquist, and he won the bronze medal at Moscow in 1980. Lane six, a man who held the world record in this event for 5 years, between 1977 and 1982, Gerald Morkin of the Federal Republic of Germany, probably past his peak as a swimmer, but still dangerous enough to figure into medal consideration here. Lane seven is the world record holder in the 200-meter breaststroke. Mark he's held since 1982, 20-year-old Victor Davis of Guelph, Canada. He is good enough to win the race if Moffitt is not sound and if Lundquist does not swim up to his talent. Lane eight, probably the only man in the field without a chance to win a medal, Raffaele Avignano, 20 years old from Italy, ranked 15th in the world last year. As I mentioned, the world and American record belongs to John Moffitt of the United States, and he now holds the Olympic record as a result of his qualifying swim this morning. His leg is taped, Mark Spitz.
Well, he certainly kept it a secret until this just moments until he just took his sweatpants off. He must really have a groin injury there, and it is legal to have it taped. This is going to be a remarkable race. I mean, I'm really excited about watching this. Lundquist used gloves on his hands because I think he probably thought he was a little cold.
Good start. They're into the water together. Steve Lundquist is known for his phenomenal starts, and he's a half body length ahead as they come up from their dive.
In this particular event, the breaststroke, the arm recovery is done underwater. That's different than the other three strokes where the recovery has to be above the water, and that creates a tremendous amount of resistance. It's a very difficult type of an arm recovery, and Lundquist knows how to do that better than anybody else in the world. Lundquist has gone out for a tremendous lead. He definitely has a psych over the rest of the field. He's not wasting any time. You're allowed to, in this turn, to pull underwater once, kick once, and break the surface.
Lundquist looked sluggish in qualifying. He touched at the 50-meter mark, nearly 3/10 of a second under world record pace. I don't believe they have a prayer of catching it. John Moffitt started out very slowly and is starting to come on. He's going to battle Peter Evans in lane five, perhaps for the silver medal. The man down in lane seven, Victor Davis, is well out in front of the other swimmers and has another shot at a silver medal himself. Lundquist is coming down to the wall. Remember, the world record is 1:02.13.
Unofficially, a new 1:01.65.
Steve Lundquist, finally fulfilling in an Olympic pool. His unbelievable talent has become the first man in history ever to swim a 100-meter breaststroke under 1 minute and 2 seconds. And believe me, It is hard to imagine that Steve Lundquist has ever felt better in his happy life than he feels right now.
We have to say that was a courageous race
a new world
for John Moffitt with that groin pull. He finished fifth. I know a big disappointment.
So the disappointment of 1980 4 years ago now becomes the disappointment of 1984 for John Moffitt. But as you say, Mark Spitz, a courageous performance, and there he receives the consolation of Steve Lundquist, who is his friend. Steve Lundquist, unquestionably the greatest breaststroke sprinter in the history of swimming, has just taken back his world record in that event. We'll be back. A helicopter shot of the Olympic swimming pool on the campus of the University of Southern California, the 100-meter breaststroke, an event in which American swimmers were once weak. In fact, Eastern European swimmers seemed to be moving ahead of American swimmers in this event 5 years ago. Now it is an American province and has been for the past few years. Steve Lundquist has just taken back a world record he previously owned. And right now, Steve Lundquist is down next to poolside. I believe in just a moment he will be ready to talk to our Diana Nyad. Second place in the event went to Victor Davis of Canada, who also went under 102 at 101.99. Peter Evans of Australia won the bronze medal. And now let's go to Diana Nyad. Diana?
You're not going to start stop smiling for days.
Steve, I asked some of the American coaches this week continually, who is it going to be? Moffitt, Lundquist, Lundquist, Moffitt. And one of them said to me, you know, that's Steve. He's a tough old Southern boy. And there you were out in an outside lane. You never looked once. You did it. The best time of your career, the best time in the world. How do you feel?
I can't express it in words. I said my goal was to make the Olympic team. And then another goal I had was to get a gold medal. And I reached both goals and with a world record. I'm very, very happy.
The water skiing accident, some of the other rough ups and downs you've had, they don't mean a thing when you get on that block, do they?
I'll tell you, I felt like the Grinch who stole Christmas and finally found his heart, you know. It's just one of those things, it feels like my heart's this big, and I couldn't be happy once again.
And I suppose it's getting toward the end of the career, just a few days now. This puts you on the relay, though, I imagine.
Yeah, it does. It's such an unfortunate thing for John. He pulled a groin muscle this morning. You know, three 100s off the world record this morning. Such a shame. But, you know, I don't mind being on the relay.
Well, I guess I'll leave this off with another Southern expression. If you weren't so ugly, you'd have everything together. Congratulations, Steve Lundquist.
Steve Lundquist, the second American gold medal. No, make it the third American gold medal so far in swimming, as Americans won two of them in the women's 100-meter free, and now this one. Now let's go quickly to Al Michaels with the men's road cycling event.